Welcome to my ASMR video. You're probably curious what an ASMR video is. Well, some of you are, some of you aren't. It's a pretty popular kind of video, but I just want to quickly explain what it is in case you don't know. ASMR is an acronym for Autonomous Sensory Meridian Response. It's basically sciencey talk for sounds that make you feel good. There's a little science to it. Basically, some people experience a trigger when they hear certain sounds, like soft talking like this, or, you know, tapping, and they experience kind of these like tingles down their back and up and down it through their spine. Not everyone who enjoys ASMR experiences that, but that's kind of like the sciencey for it. It's basically this whole subgenre of video where people just talk softly, tap on things. They do a bunch of really cool stuff, all for the purpose of relaxation. And there's so many like different like little subgenres of it. Like, there's just straight up kind of what I'm doing right now. There's videos dedicated to specific sounds. It's Some people do like role plays, like where they dress up as characters in cosplay. Other people will do like a video with no talking. It's only like, you know, using a keyboard and stuff. There's a ton of really cool stuff out there, and I've been meaning to make one of these videos for a while, since about September, in fact. And it's not that, and I just figured, why not? I finally got a webcam, thank you to my friend Alan, and I just wanted to really make a video. But this introduction's taking a while, so I kind of just want to dive right into the tapping, and I'm going to gonna ramble on while I do, because I like doing that. It's fun to just kind of be freeform, and for me in particular, I really do enjoy whispering and talky kind of ASMR. I don't really experience ASMR triggers. Sometimes I do, but more or less it's like a kind of a wind down thing for me. Like, I really enjoy it when I'm reading, just having someone kind of talk, sometimes inaudibly, just ramble stuff. It makes me kind of just feel relaxed, you know? Like when, you know, people are just kind of talking in the distance, kind of like a background noise, and because it's so quiet, it's a lot more pleasant. And I do like tapping, but it's not my favorite thing in the world. I do apologize if this is a little loud, if the audio's not the best. This is my first time, and, you know, it's very easy to obsess over something to the point of, especially when it's your first time, to obsess over something to the point where you don't actually do it. And I figure I'd rather do something badly the first time and then do better on it the second than not do it at all and not put anything out there. So that was my phone, and I got a bunch of other little things from around my house that I'm going to be working on, and tapping and stuff, things that I think will make a good sound but aren't too crazy and out there. This is a little pencil holder that coincidentally looks very similar to my microphone here. But yeah, I don't know. I just felt the need to, like, I've always wanted to make one of these because they've, not only have they just helped me relax throughout college and such, but, you know, it's a weird thing to say, but, you know, sometimes just the feeling of hearing somebody else's voice on, like, you know, after a very stressful day, and having, like, the soft voice, the something purely designed for your relaxation, it kind of just really helps. It can be kind of very, I don't know if therapeutic or cathartic is the right word, but it, I don't know, makes me feel better. And I want to hopefully provide some of that for you people out there, because things are really scary and stressful, and, you know, it can feel like we're very alone. I just kind of wanted to make something that hopefully you can come back to if you feel that way, or can just just make you forget about everything. At least for a little bit. Maybe not everything, but, you know, I want to help. Now we have here my, car's manual. And we're just going to kind of flip through it like this. Kind of looks like it's, talking and stuff. But yeah, ASMR is really, really cool. And I always loved it and stuff. And, like, I've had this microphone for almost, like, 3 years now. And I always wanted to make a video. I didn't really know how, because there's no, like, how to make an ASMR video, because there's, like, this sound that the professional, they're called ASMR artists, or, ASM artists, you know, puns, Doug like puns, so I like it. But, like, there's a specific sound that, like, the professionals, because there's some really talented people who make these really amazing, relaxing videos. There's a sound that they have, and, you know, I wondered, how do you make that sound and stuff? And kind of like what I said earlier, you can't really obsess about what you don't have, or what you aren't making. If there's one thing I learned at art school, it's that you're going to be bad at it in the beginning, but that's how you get good at something. But yeah, I've always wanted to get into this and just at least do one to say I did it. That's one of the things about graduating I'm most looking forward to. And I mean, obviously, present circumstances aside, you know, once, you know, things get better again and we can start to go out in the world, there's going to be that kind of freedom that we get for when I'm not going to be busy with school and stuff, that, you know, like, I can learn and do stuff, like make an ASMR video, or really, really want to learn how to surf and stuff. And, you know, like, that's the thing, like, I'm most looking forward to is, like, living a life and stuff. And, you know, that's the thing that's kind of keeping me going through all this, is there is stuff we can do on the other side. It's not just school, work. You know, that's the thing we're trying to get through to. It's all the life that we get to live. And, you know, that's why it's important that we take care of ourselves, each other, during this time by staying home and everything. Here's my PlayStation controller. I'm just gonna tap on this and stuff. One thing I really love about these things is, like, if you turn them on, they have these little lights here, and, like, they change colors and stuff, and I don't know, I just love all those little bells and whistles that, technology has these days, because it's, like, you know, like, just the little way, like, a text message will pop up on my phone, or, like, I have one of those, rainbow-colored, keyboards. My brother and sister got it for me for Christmas, one of those gaming ones that, like, the mouse came with it, like, changes colors when you, touch it and stuff. It's just, like, little stuff like that, like, you know, the little animal brain in us, it's just like, ooh, pretty colors. I like that stuff. And then, like, this bar here will change to the color of this and stuff. And, there was one game I was playing where, you had a flashlight, and this part here would glow when you, turned on the flashlight. And then you had to, like, shake it if the batteries and your flashlight weren't working in the game and stuff. It's just really cool and stuff, just, like, how much technology works with itself and everything. Yeah, this reminds me a lot of my fidget cube, actually. I don't know where it is, but, I have a fidget cube, and I also have a fidget spinner right here. I remember when these came out, everyone was kind of, like, making fun of them, because, like, there were all the, I think it was the Vines back then, too, date when fidget spinners came out and stuff, but, you know, it was kind of, like, the thing that everyone was kind of digging on and stuff, and having one of these, and also having a fidget cube, it's, like, I'm really happy to have it. Don't know what this says about me, but, like, when I'm talking or writing or anything, it's just good because it gives me something to do instead of, like, getting up and pacing. I can just spin it and you know, like I'm talking about that little animal brain in us, like this just kind of awakens this kind of like, ooh, spinny thing. I like it. It feels good. It just, I don't know, it feels good to fidget with stuff. And I'm happy there are things out there that can scratch that itch. We're kind of moving along with all these here. So here is my little Yoshi 3DS. Had this for years. Really liked it. It was either this or pink. And unfortunately, when I got this, I was not brave enough to rock the pink quite yet. But Yoshi's cool too. I always like that little clicking noise it makes when you open and close it. Really love the sound of like buttons and clicking and stuff. My first experience with ASMR actually was long before I even knew what it was when I would like take math tests and stuff, and people were clicking into the calculators and stuff. Like, I was always one of those students who liked to rush through a test to, you know, just kind of try to relax and not stress so much. If like I didn't know something, I didn't know it. And I think part of the reason why, like, finishing early, like, obviously there's, like, all the jokes about, you know, the people finishing first really kind of freak everyone else out, but there was this really nice thing about knowing that, like, you were done with it, and I think part of that relaxation kind of tied into just hearing people typing into their calculators, and that extends to just, you know, typing on computers and, you know, pressing buttons on a DS. ASMR is just like this really, really cool thing, and I hope I'm doing a decent job of showing you how cool it can be and how relaxing it is. But like, there's just something like, there's so much creativity in these videos that, you know, I really hope I can explore that in the future, because like, there are some videos that, you know, will like take sounds from nature, some videos where it's just like some like really cool but weird stuff. Like one of my personal favorites is the kind of like there's an audible whisper where people are kind of saying these saying stuff, but they're not really saying anything, or they're saying it at such a low volume that you can't really hear it, but it's just like the faintest like echo of a noise almost. It is really cool. And then, you know, there's some other ones like mouth sounds, which I'm not really fond of. It's like lip smacking and just kind of the sound of like vowels and consonants in your mouth moving, basically all kinds of stuff. One of my really favorite ones actually is role play ASMRs. Like people basically do this like cosplay stuff from like anything from like Star Wars, Lord of the Rings, a bunch of anime stuff. It's just really, really cool. And you know, like I've always wanted to get into cosplay, so like I would love to one day do one of those. Although I don't know if it would be I do cosplay and then make an ASMR video with a costume, or if I make a costume for ASMR and then use it for cosplay. But you know, it's like it's just really cool stuff that like one of the nice things about kind of growing up and definitely about going to school for the performing arts is you get kind of used to, well, you get over yourself in a way. You don't worry so much about what people think almost. Like one thing that I see a lot on like online, on like social media and stuff, is people talking about cringe and stuff, and I always kind of hated that word for, you know, I mean, one, it's like no one likes to cringe about stuff, but it's like, you know, it's kind of like this weird shaming thing people can do sometimes, where it's like, oh, that's cringe, bro, and that was cringe me saying it. But like, I saw this really nice thing on Twitter that really resonated with me, where a person, and it was a joke, but the person said, "I might be cringe, but I'm free." And that just really, really resonated with me for some reason. And I think that's kind of it, you know? Like, if you're really enjoying yourself, someone who's not comfortable in their own skin is probably going to feel embarrassed. But if it's making you happy, then honestly, it's okay if someone cringes, or even if you cringe a little bit. Because, you know, I think the things that make us feel the best are the things that kind of make us feel a little uncomfortable and such. So, yep. I'm cringe, but I am free. Alright. So I've got one more trigger for you. Water. What are we waiting for? This probably has to be one of my favorite triggers. It's this weird thing where, like, there are so many ASMR videos out there that, like, when I try to find a specific ASMR trigger, and when I say a trigger, it's not like a psychological, like, trauma trigger. It's just, like, you know, a response to a specific sound. You know, the best examples I can use is how, like, there are some sounds people just don't like. Like, for me, my least favorite sound is, it's like this kind of, fabric, like this kind of plastic fabric that they used to use when I was in elementary school for, like, putting, like, note cards in and stuff, like, how they would keep track of us when we were out at lunch and stuff. Like, scratching that just made me feel awful. And then ASMR is, like, the opposite of it. But anyways, water triggers are my favorite. I've always loved the water, even if I'm an awful swimmer. But, there's something peaceful about just hearing water in its entirety. And, you know, that was the one thing I kind of regret about OU, is that I didn't get to spend more time at the pool. I really should have taken advantage of it now that I can't. But, like, when I go looking for specific ASMR triggers, I usually, when it's like there's a video dedicated to that one trigger, it doesn't do it for me. But, like, if I watch a video and someone has, like, a water bottle for, like, 30 seconds, I'll go back and rewatch those 30 seconds, like, 6 times. And it's so weird how it's, like, the stuff you like, if you find a bunch of it, can be almost, like, diminishing returns almost. But when it's, like, you know, an unexpected thing, it feels so much more better. And I don't know, that's just a weird musing of me and my experience with ASMR. But I like water. I really want to see the ocean again. I went once as a kid, and I just really want to visit it as an adult. You know, it's probably not going to be anything special, but I don't know. There's just this kind of peace I feel when I'm near the water. But, I kind of want a little bit of that. I think we all want a little bit of peace. And, I just had a thought that I wanted to share, because of that. I hope I could bring you a little bit of peace right now with this fun little experiment into a new art form. This is a really scary time, and it's really easy to feel alone, and it's really easy to feel bad, and, you know, that's okay. I think right now an important thing is to be honest with ourselves that this situation really does kind of suck, and when we're in better places, we can ask ourselves, how did we get here, and what can we do to fix things, and what can we do to make sure we're never in this situation again? But I think the important thing is that we need to take care of ourselves, so that way we can get to a point where we can have those kinds of conversations and ask those kinds of questions. And to take care of ourselves and to be kind with ourselves before then. You know, most of us are isolated in one way or another. We aren't around all the people that we wish we could be. And it can feel very easy to feel bad. And the worst thing we can do is to shame ourselves for it. Shame is such a horrible emotion, and I don't want to get too philosophical with all this, but, you know, I guess I just want to leave with a little message, especially to my, like, creative-type friends out there. You know, making stuff is great. You know, friend shared with me recently a great thought, and it's that, you know, art is putting ourself into the world. And it doesn't just mean sharing something on Facebook or Instagram. It's, you know, it's the stuff in here and the stuff in here just coming out here. And, you know, I think that's the important thing to remember, is that, you know, just, we aren't trying to make products right now. We aren't trying to, I don't know, further our careers or whatever. Like, if we can make art from this time, that's amazing, but it's not a bad thing if we can't. And for, you know, all the other people who don't usually make art and stuff, like, art should be an escape. It should be a celebration. It should be a catharsis. It should be a lot of things, but, you know, it should be something that we shame ourselves for. And I guess that's the thing I want to say before I ramble on for too long, is don't shame yourself for how you're feeling right now. You know, just be kind. The most important job we have right now is to take care of ourselves, to be there when, you know, the first day of going back to normal, to be there for that. So, I guess with that, thank you so much for watching and hopefully enjoying this. Please take care of yourselves. If you want to, make a little art, do a little doodle, sing a little song for yourself, but just, above all, do something nice for yourself. You really deserve it. But thank you for watching. Take care of yourself. I'm Doug. Bye-bye.